Please join the choir in singing Silent Night.
Oh, We will begin on page 78.
Vai tu calopole, vectam bendilox adet, melcus maio no asolic dati.
Days of our lives and forever.
Amen.
be nor an end. You are the hidden light who shines upon the world. In the ancient of days born as a child from the daughter of David. Today we celebrate the mystery of your love for us, proclaiming you are wonderful, O God. You became man, yet you are still God. You are wonderful, O God. You came down to us and were born in a manger, yet you fill heaven and earth with your glory. You are wonderful, O God. The angels, shepherds, and magi came to adore you. By your birth, you tore down the walls, separating heavenly and earthly beings, reconciling heaven and earth. By your birth, you brought together those who are far and those who are near to celebrate your feast. At your birth, the angels announced to the shepherds, to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah of the Lord. Now, O wondrous child, we ask you, with the fragrance of this incense, to help us to understand the mystery of your incarnation. Forgive our sins, free us from all distress, and remember our departed who have gone to their rest, hoping in you. We raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father and your Holy Spirit, forever.
Accept our incense. Forgive our sins.
and grant rest to our departed. We raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and your Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen. Please stand.
Your kingdom. your companions. And in the beginning, Lord, you founded the earth and the heavens of the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain. They will all wear out like clothing. Like a cloak, you will roll them up, and like clothing, they will be changed. But you are the same, and your years will never end.
Praise be to God always.
The shepherds returned
glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. This is the truth, peace be with you. Taken care of. didn't exist, we wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be here. So we have to be very careful of what we're listening to, what we're interpreting, how we are making our decisions, what is motivating us. Coming back to this little child, I was just thinking how much anxiety must have been in the minds of Mary and Joseph traveling. You know, they didn't have UPS or Sirius to find their favorite radio station. Dual control so that the person on the left can be warmer than the one on the right, and the people in the back can be another gauge there so that they can have it colder or warmer. And maybe even watching something. They were scared, I'm sure they were. What's going to happen? What could be more scary than traveling and expecting? And knowing that they have to register, knowing that they had to register is because the Romans did not trust them. Wanted to keep strict records of who they are, where they are, and what they're doing in case they were going to try to throw over the Romans. It was a type of humiliation. Being forced to do what ordinarily they would have not done, but they did it. They went to Bethlehem, and they fulfilled the prophecy. We have a little baby here. Even understanding the angels, they said they were terrified and scared. And that's the part where I also want to key on. You know, this is my 10th Christmas year. I skipped a year because I was home. You know, my mother had passed away and did the funeral the day after Christmas. But 11 years here. And I've been able to witness the pain and the hurts and the turmoil and the tensions, and the fears. I think I've done more funerals in the last 12 months than probably in my first 10 years. So I know what kind of grief can be out there, what kind of pain, and the sense of loss. And sometimes maybe it would have been nice if we didn't have to deal with any of this, that maybe these fundamentalist thinking would have come in handy for us. But God wanted me to exist. And he wanted you to exist. And in some plan that's mysterious, we're not sure why, things happen where it causes incredible agony and pain and disappointment in our lives. Some of us have probably had anxiety attacks. The world is just as much in need of the voice of a saving Lord that loves us as on this dark night. We don't need to give up. We are in a world where we are warned of terrorists. Attacks. But the real terror that we probably really are going to experience is our own thoughts, our own interpretations, our own agony, and whatever that might be. Each one of us has a type of personality that there is somewhere in us that we might feel quite empty. Or confused, or struggling, or doubt. All of that can't be all solved in one night. Not 4,000 years ago for creation, but who could measure it? The plan of God is so immense, you can't measure it in years and centuries. the universe that's out there. In our own life, we don't know when Jesus is going to return. But we do know we need him to return constantly in our own personal life. When we're filled with doubt, unsureness, have a problem that we can't sort out, or maybe it's not our problem. Maybe it's the problem of somebody that we really love and we're agonizing over there. That maybe we're watching them walk in the wrong direction, and if they don't turn around, they might be one of the statistics that we see in the obituary or in the news. For myself, I'm a cool guy. I don't fret over nothing, right, servers? I come in strong if there's not a tear in my mind. La 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 la, let's do jumping jacks today. Actually, I do that sometimes. I'll say, what are we going to do different this week? And I said, instead of doing frontward somersaults, we're going to do backward somersaults when we process. I forgot to mention it. One of my servers asked me, well, what are we going to do different today? And I said, what would you like to do? He said, well, the story keeps going. Become childlike again. Those ways that we find to know that sometimes we have to go where we're uncomfortable, we're a little bit fearful, that we're not sure of ourselves at different times. How will it turn out? Will it work out? Will there be mistakes? All of us have that going on in our life. The worst thing that can happen is to decide to do nothing. I encourage you, and I encourage myself, to continue to step forward. That we do have a Lord and Savior. He knows what is wrong. He knows our weaknesses. He knows how stubborn we are. I don't know any stubborn people, but I had to throw that in there because it's theological. But he loves us. He loves us as long as we continue to ask for forgiveness and are willing to forgive others. If we're willing to keep focusing on the love that God has for us, that the work is not finished. We are still in process. We're still moving. We still need to change the world more than what we have changed it so far. And pray to God that we don't backslide back into the horrors of the past. But it needs the Prince of Peace, the Consoler of the soul. It needs the embrace of a loving Father. That the embrace isn't to humiliate us, but to heal us. To know that he never gives up on us. He never grows weary. He never grows tired. He never says, not again. But what he does say, don't give up. I will walk with you. I will do my best to change the hearts of the people that they are not going to be throwing the stones. That your name is precious on my lips. You are my son. You are my daughter. Today, we take a unique look. For today, a fragile, humble, little child, not scared, but invited. Take a good look at him, and take a look at yourself, and know how much he wants to live inside of you. I will do my best to walk with you through your sorrows, through your confusion, through the mistakes, because I know healing comes from the Lord, that it is this message that can change the world. If you don't like it the way it is, let this message change you and play your part in your place in changing the world around you.
We have two envelopes today, so if you are using your envelopes, you may put them both in the first collection.
sending your Son into the world. Give us the faith and the willingness to take good care of him, to protect him, to worship him, to turn to him when we need him. We're thankful that we live in a country that we can freely worship as Christians. And we pray for those in other places that are in fear of their life. But let us be proud of who we are, that we dare to stand and profess our belief in the one God.
Page 748.
We believe
in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made,
You accept the offerings of our ancestors. Now accept these offerings that your children brought to you out of the love for you in your holy name. Shower your spiritual blessings upon them and place on their earth their gifts. Grant them life in your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ in his plan of salvation for us, we call upon this offering our Lord to please God from Adam to this day. Especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom the sacrifice is offered, for St. Joseph's parish, the living and the deceased. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Amen.
Thank you.
and the communion and calling out the Holy Spirit be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our thoughts, our minds, and our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord with reverence and worship Him with humility.
It is right and just.
Truly it is right and just to glorify and exalt you. O Maker of all creation, with the angels we glorify you. And with voice of praise we cry out and proclaim holy.
We praise you, we bless you, we worship you.
protect our shepherds. Francis, the Pope of Rome, Bishop Peter, our patriarch, Antioch, and Gregory, John, our bishop, assist the priests, the deacons, and all those who serve your holy church, so that they may intercede and pray to you on our behalf. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, those who have asked us to pray for them, those who desired but weren't able to make an offering, and those who assist your holy church. Be a shelter and a refuge for them, for you are the Savior of all. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, remember the civil leaders in our country and throughout the world. Enlighten their consciences to bring security and peace to your people. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those who struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for peace throughout the world and an end to war and all acts of violence and hatred. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the Holy Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors, Saint Joseph, Saint Jude, Saint Maron, Saint Charbel, and all the saints. Assist us through their prayers and make us worthy of their reward. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the righteous fathers and teachers who have gone to their rest among the saints. Remember those who diligently carried out your gospel through the whole world and confirmed your holy church in the true faith. Assist us through their prayers and strengthen us in your love. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Favorably remember, O Lord, our parents, brothers and sisters, teachers, and all the faithful departed, especially those who have passed away recently. Here and everywhere, we have gone to the rest, especially the members of St. Joseph's. Forgive us, and forgive them of all sins and offenses. Through our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins we have committed, with or without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God. Forgive us and the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things, with the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
You are the Lord.
lead us not into the trials of temptation, that we do not have the strength to overcome, but deliver us from every evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, with your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of him and receive the blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, bless your worshipers who bow before you and implore you. Make them worthy of your mercy and forgive their sins. For your almighty and rich in compassion, we raise glory and thanks to you and your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most High Trinity, eternal consubstantial, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our community be for the forgiveness of our sins and for new life. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever.
Amen.
Again and again, we thank you, O Lord, to praise the glory to you, for giving us your body to eat and your living blood to drink. O lover of all people, have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us.
with you.
And with your spirit.
Lord Jesus, stretch forth your right hand and bless your people. Protect them by your cross. Be their shelter and refuge and perfect them with your abundant blessings. That we may raise glory and thanks to you, your blessed Father, and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Please stand.
I did forget the man to my right, but we can see. Thank you for May the blessing